You can take off your shoes if you want to. Get comfortable. Welcome to the show.
This show is really particularly special because we constructed it really from the ground up, and the kids played such an integral role in building what it is. We picked a theme that was broad, the theme of life, which could be almost anything, but we decided we wanted to show things that showed, you know, every range of life from being really young to getting really old and everything in between. And then the kids went out and they found monologues and scenes. Some of them wrote their own pieces. They came up with song suggestions that were incorporated in. So this was really a big labor of love. And as much as we want to entertain, I think, and what's really great, and my colleagues agree, the way we look at art isn't just about something, you know, fun, and it should be, and it is fun, but it's also designed to make you feel something. And the students understand that as well. And so today we hope to make you laugh. We hope to make you cry in a good way. And we hope to make you think and have fun. So thank you.
Come to the end of our journey.
Yep, you guessed it,
Dad. Hannah,
we just started the show. Let's not give away the ending.
I think they know how the show's gonna end.
It's not the ending of the show that matters. It's the journey.
Wow, that's deep.
I know.
And so,
without further ado,
through a combination of music,
dance,
scenes,
and monologues,
we present to you
our artistic exploration of life. What do you think, silly? Where all life begins. At the beginning!
Three, the unexpected children, simultaneously mature.
this song to Mrs. Goldenwasser of her major operation when she had her twins. But when mother came along, she silences the others. She accomplished something that is very rare in mothers. MGM has got a Leo, but Mama has got a trio. She is proud and says three is so proud. We do everything alike. We look alike. We dress alike. We walk alike. We talk alike. And what is more, we hate each other very much. We hate our folks. We're sick of jokes. And what a mark it is to tell some parts.
I really don't think it's much to ask. I've done everything he told me to do in your letter last year. I've stopped hitting my little brother. I don't complain very much, only when I have to do homework. I even donated 7 toys to Goodwill yesterday because Mom said I don't have enough space in my room for anything more. So, I'm ready, Santa. I'm only asking for one thing this year. And you can try to steer me away from it all you want by telling me how you made a new truck this year and how there's so many things I can do with a new set of blocks and how there are free books out there you know like. But it won't stop me from asking for this. I know you're gonna listen, so I'll tell you again. I want a super power machine that'll make me fast like the Flash, create force fields like the Green Lantern, and make me fly like Superman. Or one of your reindeers. It's not too much to ask. I look forward to Christmas morning.
I thought I told you kids to go to bed!
Okay, 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 we're going!
You really witchy.
Well, my mother made my outfit, and I'll bet it's neater than yours anytime.
It is not.
It's a whole lot scarier than the ones you go out and buy. We looked at the ones in the stores, and they were dorky.
You won't scare anyone.
My witch is scary. Scarier than yours any day. I put it on last night and I jumped out from behind the porch at my brother. He got so scared he had to sleep with his lights on.
Well, my mother made me long stringy hair and a pointy nose.
She even taught me how to cackle like a witch. Ha 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 ha! You sound more like a chicken than a witch.
Oh yeah? How do you know what a witch sounds like?
Because I saw one in this movie one time, Snow White. She cackled like this.
That's a stupid cackle.
Oh yeah? Well, you're just mad because my cackle's better than your cackle.
It is not!
You don't know anything about witches!
They put spells on people.
And turn people into stuff. And fly around on broomsticks. And keep bats around as pets.
Well, my mother made me a paper bat too.
And mine bought me this big stuffed cat that lights up with green eyes and makes really weird noises.
You sound more like you're sick than a cat.
Well, still be a better witch than you will.
I'll bet I'll get twice as much candy when we go trick-or-treating than you do.
That's because you have a bigger bat. That's why I'm greedy.
No, it's because I'll be a better witch than you. I have an idea. How about I be a witch this year and you can be a witch next year?
No way, Jose. Wait, Kiki. I have an idea. How about you be a big fat mouse? You've got the face for it.
Well, at least I won't look like some silly nerd in some silly snowball witch outfit!
I'm not talking to you any longer!
Well, me neither! Not till Halloween's over anyhow!
The teenage years.
Dad, will you let me take the car out tonight? I'm going to be 16 in 2 weeks.
Yeah, technically my learner's permit requires you in the car with me.
Technically, I have to wait 2 weeks until I get my license.
No, but you already know I can drive. You told me that I'm better than Mom. I can do a three-point turn, parallel park, and I exert the traffic laws like a religion. So it's not like you're responsible or anything to let me drive, because you already know I'm awesome at it.
Gosh, this is so unfair! You know you're going to ruin my social life!
See, the coolest girls in freshman year, the ones who are all probably making huge donations at Mom's gala tonight and live in the massive houses up on the hill and won't talk to me, yeah, they started talking to me because they needed a ride to the dance. And I was all like, I can take you. And they were all like, you're 16. And I was all like, yeah. And then they said, cool. And I've been eating lunch with them every single day this week and they're all so excited. I mean, it was well thought out. You and Mom were supposed to be at her benefit gala thing tonight. You weren't supposed to be stuck at home with some messed up fever. If I let them down, if I don't get in that car right now, I better might as well be. I'll be mocked, marked, and probably shunned. My entire high school experience will become a living nightmare! I'm not being dramatic. I'm being accurate, Dad. This is how things go. So I'm begging you, just go to sleep. And I'll still be here in exactly 3 hours, right before Mom gets back. Please, Dad, my life depends on it.
Don't disobey me!
Don't contradict me!
Don't even think about going to that object, Ken.
Please!
No!
Mother!
Stop!
Stop telling me what to do.
Don't!
Don't treat me like a child of two.
No!
Please!
But mother, please,
give it all back!
No?
She will.
She's going to be proud.
I skipped school.
Good cause, you know. Good cause.
I don't know.
I'm telling you.
I know.
I'm just saying.
I know.
Do you love us?
I do.
Then trust us.
Okay.
Call your mom.
I'll just do it later.
This is big.
I know.
You are going to be on American Idol.
I know.
Wait,
what?
You're gonna get big and then you're gonna love us less.
No?
But you'll be driving around in limos and doing your thing and we'll be back here and you won't even know us anymore.
I will always know you.
But you'll be known.
I guess.
Sick.
I know.
I didn't even know you signed up.
I guess I forgot to tell you.
What'd you sing?
I'm hungry.
You wanna go out?
No.
What do you want?
Never mind, I'm not really hungry.
Okay.
I'm going home.
What?
I'm tired.
How the heck can you be tired?
I lied.
What?
I lied.
What does that even mean?
I was at the library.
What?
All day today, I took the train to the big library in Brooklyn.
Are you serious?
I'm serious.
What?
I'm leaving.
I don't think so.
You don't get to choose.
You lied.
I lied.
You're a liar.
I guess.
God!
You're the worst.
What?
Never mind, I didn't mean that.
What is wrong with you?
Nothing. Don't judge me.
We aren't.
You always judge me.
No, we don't.
Well, do more. Be more then.
Sure, we want you to do things.
Well, maybe I can.
Yes, you can.
No, I don't think so. You want me to be someone I'm not.
Don't tell us how we feel.
Well, I'm leaving.
Go ahead.
I am.
Go ahead.
Really?
Really, go ahead.
But you want me to leave, right? Because I'm a liar.
You're like a crazy person.
I think you're right. I'm crazy.
You need some help.
I want you to help me.
Emily!
No, I just want you to think I'm special.
We do.
No, you don't.
Stop telling us how we feel!
Look at me. Do you think that I'm like Beyonce or who's that one you like from like the movie with the car? Am I like that?
I don't need you to be.
But I need you to be a movie star? I don't think so.
I just want to be someone else.
Go ahead! But don't come up with crazy lies.
Do you love me?
Yes, when you're honest.
So those few minutes I lied, you didn't love me?
No.
Just like that?
Don't try and mix this up.
I guess I am a little crazy.
A little?
Of course you're a little crazy. We all are.
I love you guys.
We love you too. Just don't come up with any more crazy lies.
I won't.
Promise.
Promise.
Now let's go eat.
Okay.
Adulthood.
I just took the longest, most amazing nap of a lifetime. Rest of the stomach, of course.
Good morning, you too. You're a little late for the interview, Miss Dempsey, by about an hour. Did you bring a copy of your resume?
A resume? Oh, yeah, it's in here somewhere. Here you are.
Tell me a bit about yourself.
Well, I've been taking time off lately, traveling around the United States. I try and experience the bathrooms in every state. Do you know how diverse the toilet facilities are across this wide nation? So far, I think Nevada's winning, but Oregon facilities just have
What are your strengths?
Well, I talk to anybody about any subject. There's never a dull moment when I'm in the room. My favorite subject to talk about is how and why the chicken crossed the road.
The chicken?
Yeah, you know the joke, right?
Sure.
Actually, I view it more as a philosophical question regarding our existence in this universe. You see, the chicken...
What are your weaknesses?
Can't think of any. Wow. I'm blanking. Honestly, I think I'm too late. Oh, yeah! I have a weakness for rocky
coffee run ice cream, I bet I can eat an entire mountain sugar in a minute. Also, I like to sleep really late. I'm much more of a night owl than an early bird. Sure, the early bird gets the worm, but who wants worms anyway?
Why exactly do you want to work here?
Well, I figured I'd be able to get free meals at that restaurant. Also, I'm living at home with my mom, and she lets me pay rent. Why? Don't ask.
What was a recent job or volunteer position you had?
The last job I had was babysitting back in 8th grade, though, and it didn't last too long.
Why did you leave this position?
Well, you see, me and the kids don't always see eye to eye. Sometimes I want a mac and cheese for dinner and they want a pizza. And I had to be nice to those kids and they obviously did not serve my charm. Who likes pizza over mac and cheese anyway? Little brats.
Do you have any questions for me?
Do you validate me? May I please see your restrooms?
Like a fish plucked from the ocean, tossed into a foreign stream. Always knew that I was different, often fled into a dream. I ignored the raging currents, right against the tide I swam. But I floated with the question, who will love me? Like an odd, exotic creature on display inside a zoo. Hearing children asking questions makes me ask some questions too. Could we bend the laws of nature? Could a lion love a lamb? Who could see beyond this surface? Who will love me as I am? Who will ever come? Proudly stand beside me, who will love me as I am?
Like a clown whose tears cause laughter, trapped inside the centering, always seeing smiling faces, I am lonely pondering.
Who would want to join this madness? Who could change my
about marriage. How do I know when I've met the right person? I think my dad's answer was the funniest. He said, "When I tell you it's the right person." He did not think that was as funny as I did. My mother emphasized partnership. She said that marriage is often like a business agreement and that I should marry someone who I can work well with. That makes sense, but isn't very romantic if you ask me. My aunt told me to make sure that whomever I marry is financially reliable. She said that should be at the top of my list. Of course, she has been divorced twice now. Oh, but she does drive a fabulous Audi convertible. My favorite teacher said that I would be happy with anyone who can make me laugh. My best friend's mom said that someone who is kind and attentive is the key. That sounds really good. Oh, but my best friend, her daughter, has chosen anyone famous to be the item at the top of her list. Famous for what? I asked her. It doesn't matter, she said, yikes. But I think my grandfather had the best advice of all. Last summer,
He and I went for a walk while my whole family was up at their house for a visit. And I asked him, Grandpa, how do I know when I've met the person I want to marry? He did not answer for a long time. And before he did, a small and certain smile spread across his face. He said, marry someone you want to be old with. I didn't quite get it at first. But later that evening, my younger cousins were out catching fireflies. It was a nice night with a barbecue and ice cream. All the kids were running around my grandparents' yard. All the adults were telling funny stories at the table. Everyone except for my grandmother and grandfather. They sat separately from the rest of the group in the two large Adirondack chairs that overlooked everything. Neither one spoke. They just sat there with small, contented smiles while my grandfather stroked my grandmother's hand. Someone you want to be old with. Yeah, I really like that.
Well, Mom. Hi, honey, how was your day?
It's all right.
Did you get your report card?
No.
Mom, Mikey's having this party tonight. Can I go?
Oh, sure, after you finish all your homework. What's this?
Mom, you know that's my private stuff.
It's my house and my stuff.
What are you looking for anyway?
I don't know, maybe your report card?
I was gonna show you, but I forgot.
No excuses, you're always trying to hide stuff from me.
It's only 1G, it's not that big of a deal.
Of course it is! How do you expect to get into a good college when you can't keep your grades up? And don't even think about going to Maggie's party tonight.
Mom, that's so unfair! Everyone's going tonight! And I'm gonna be the only person who's not going because my mommy said I couldn't.
Well, I'm sorry, but I can't let you get away with this.
Mom, you can't. My reputation will be ruined.
I can and I will. You will enter my house, or you're going to follow my rules.
You're always making rules. Why don't I make a few of my own?
Why don't you just stick being a teenager for now?
It'd be a lot easier to be a teenager if I had a real mom.
What's this about?
Nothing.
Everything?
It's just like you're never around, and I always have to do everything by myself.
Well, you are 17. I thought you wanted to be alone.
Whoever wants to be alone?
Well, I thought you did. You always lock yourself up in your room like you never want to see me.
Are you kidding me? I love you, Mom. It's just that sometimes I need my space, but other times I need you to invade. And truth is, I was really nervous about this grade, but I didn't know how to tell you without you getting upset.
Honey, I'm so sorry. You should never have to feel like this. How about we order some pizza and get all this homework done? I know it's not as cool as Mikey's party, but I think it is.
You're not that cool, Mom.
Lazy loafers, walk to the next kiss. You can talk and talk to your face.
I was on time.
No, you were late.
Yes, I remember it well. We dined with friends.
We dined alone.
A tenor sang.
A baritone.
Yes, I remember it well. That dazzling April moon.
There was none that night, and the month was June.
That's right, that's right.
It warms my heart to know that you'll remember still the way you do.
Yes, I remember it well. How often I've thought of that Friday night when we had our last rendezvous. And somehow I foolishly wondered if you might by some chance be thinking of it too. That carriage ride,
you walked me home,
you lost the glove,
you lost the car.
Yes, I remember it well. A brilliant sky.
We had some rain.
Those Russian songs.
From Sunny Spain.
Yes, I remember it well. You wore a gown of gold.
I was in blue.
Am I getting old?
Oh no, not you. How strong you were. How dark and gay.
Yes, I remember it well.
The autumn years.
Grandpa, how did you and Grandma meet?
We met in biology class, I think it was.
You met in college?
Yes. I remember seeing her for the first time and just thinking about how beautiful she was.
Did you talk to her?
I was nervous at first, but I eventually worked up enough courage to ask her to a dance.
You used to dance?
Yes, and if I remember correctly, I was an amazing dancer.
Really?
You should have seen me move.
Oh, I was something. Young, strong. Oh, I was something in days gone by. With some girl who just happened to catch my eye. Slim, straight, light on my feet, shoes just skimming the ground. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, follow the beat. Around, around, around. All night, circling the floor, till dawn lit up the sky. Younger than I in days gone by.
I know one younger than I in days gone by.
Did you see that man? Hardly even looked at you. People are so rude. Oh, here, I will reuse a little bag. The problem is, everybody's on their smartphone these days. My granddaughter, Maureen, has one, and she's 9 years old. 9! She should be outside playing in the sunshine, don't you think? I don't get it anymore. Now, if you're on a bus or in line, you're just texting or something, not making conversations like this, you know. And that's what gets right down to it. I gave my grandson a book to play with, and he tried swiping the pages instead of turning them. Can you believe that? Ugh. I miss the days where people actually paid attention to their surroundings and the people in them. But now we miss so much just because we're absorbed in these little silicone worlds. Oh, what did you say? Cash or debit? Debit, right. I get so carried away sometimes. Did you see that man? Hardly even looked at you. People are so rude. Oh, here. I have a reusable bag. The problem is everybody's on their smartphone these days. My granddaughter, Grain, has one, and she's only 9 years old. 9. She should be outside playing in the sunshine, don't you think? Isn't it good for people to stare at screens all day? I read a thing that says if you stare at a screen for too long, it can lead to blindness or cancer. Either way, seems like a bad thing. Nowadays, people just don't sit with their thoughts. When you're on a bus or in a line, you're just texting or something. You're not making connections, talking to people, you know, like this. And that's what gets right down to it. My grandson had a book that I gave him. He tried to swipe the pages instead of turning them. Unbelievable. I miss the days where people actually paid attention to their surroundings and the people in them. We miss so much just because we're absorbed in these little silicone worlds. Oh, what did he say? Cash or debit? Debit. I get so carried away sometimes.
Feels on the minds of a like, are you kidding? Just because I'm not making a big deal of it doesn't mean you just assume and take my last piece of birthday cake.
Seriously, that is so rude.
Right?
She's always been that way.
I know. She's entitled, that's the problem. Hey, Chelsea, what was the thing she said to you on that field trip?
Hello, Earth to Chelsea.
Huh? Oh, sorry.
Are you okay?
What do you think happens when you die?
What? Way to take the conversation dark, Chels.
No, really, what do you think happens?
Why?
Well, my grandmother's really sick and I'm just wondering what you guys think.
Oh, sorry.
We didn't know.
So, any thoughts?
I saw on the Discovery Channel where a long time ago, before the beginning of time, the whole universe was as small as the head of a pin. And everything was inside of it. Stars, planets, people, cars, and even other pins. And then one day, the side of the pin just exploded and everything came out, a million degrees hot and a million miles an hour. They just kept on spinning and melting until they took up all the space and all the time. Since then, I realized I was just like that pin. And that one day, I'm gonna explode too. And when I do, I'll be everywhere all at once.
I sing the body electric. I celebrate the me yet to come. I toast to my own reunion when I become one.
Share with everyone the meaning of life if you're so multi-talented.
Okay, maybe I will. You see, it's quite simple, actually. The clues were woven in since the beginning of the show. The meaning of life is...